let us continue with the problem. So till now we have seen that house property self-occupied, one is before 1/4/1999, one is after 1/4/1999. So for self-occupied property, GAV is nil, municipal tax is nil, net annual value is also nil, deductions is also nil. So interest on loan we have taken for 1/4/1999. The house property purchased before 1/4/1999. So least of the following we have taken. Actual interest paid is 2,25,000, max is 30. So least of the following is 30 we have taken. This is option number 1. If the house property is, if the loan is taken after 1/4/1999, so it is taken after 1/4/1999 means 2014. 2014 means after 1/4/1999. Okay, so now same, least of the following will be allowed as deduction. Least of the following. Okay, so small a. What is small a? Actual interest. B is how much? Max 2 lakhs. Okay, so actual interest is given in the question, 2,75,000. Actual interest is 2,75,000. So 2,75,000, 2 lakhs, whichever is least, least is 2 lakhs. So 2 lakhs will be taken as deduction. Okay, so in both the cases, self-occupied property, there will be a loss. So first house, there is a loss. First, if the loan is taken before 1/4/1999, the loss is loss from house property. First house is 30,000. Second house is 2 lakhs. Okay. So simple. So we have taken the example, and in that we have to compute house property for self-occupied property. In both the cases, the self-occupied property, there will be a loss. There will be a loss. Loss from house property for first, the loan taken before 1/4/1999 is 30,000, and for after 1/4/1999 is 2 lakhs. So we have seen here, before 1/4/1999, actual interest is 2,75,000, max is 30,000. That we have to remember. This point we have to remember, 30,000, and max 2 lakhs. We have to remember this point. So least of the following is 30. So we have written here 30,000. Loss from house property is 30, and 1/4 after we have taken loan on 2014. So 1/4/1999 means 2 lakhs. Interest actual paid is 2,75,000. Max is 20,000. 2 lakhs. Least is 2 lakhs. So both the cases there is a loss. Okay. Chale. Let us move further and solve one more problem. Example will solve. Mr. Bhattacharya owns a house property in Kolkata and furnishes the following information particulars. So he is giving some information. From that information you have to find out income from house property of Mr. Bhattacharya. So what is given? Rent received. Rent received means actual rent. Rent received means ARV. How much is ARV? 1,80,000. Next is standard rent. How much is standard rent? 1,70,000. Municipal rental value is 1,75,000. Fair rental value is 1,85,000. Municipal taxes 10% plus 5% of municipal taxes as sanitation charges. So first we have to calculate 10% of municipal charges. This 10% will be always on municipal rental. So this municipal taxes will be always paid, the percentage will be given. So always calculate on municipal rental value plus 5% of municipal taxes. We have to take sanitary charges. Sanitation charges. So compute a net annual value. He is asking only net annual value. Interest on loan is not given. So till only net annual value, no deductions are given. So no need of calculation deductions. Okay. So we have to solve till only net annual value. So let us start solving this problem. So we have to compute income of from house property. I have written page number 178 and question number 7. Write computation of income from house property of Mr. Bhattacharya. for the AY 2021. Okay, so first we have to find out gross annual value. So for this we used to do working note 1. So let me do working note number 1 here. So step number 1, calculation of ERV. So how to calculate ERV? MRV, FRV, whichever is high. How much is MRV? MRV is 1,75,000, FRV is 1,85,000. So 1,75,000, 1,85,000. So highest is 1,85,000. So ERV is 1,85,000. Next we have to calculate adjusted ERV. These steps we know already, right? So how to find out standard rent or ERV, whichever is low. Standard rent is how much? Standard rent is 1,70,000. 1,70,000, 1,85,000. Whichever is low. Low, what is low? 1,70,000 is low. So adjusted ERV is 1,70,000. Next step number 3. Calculation of GAV. How to calculate adjusted ERV or ARV, whichever is high. Okay, so we have a net received is 1,80,000. So actual rental value is 1,80,000 and adjusted ERV is 1,70,000. So highest is 1,80,000. So 1,80,000 is what? GAV. So simple, we know the steps high, low, high. We have done, we got GAV 1,80,000. So I got 1,80,000 as GAV. Okay, less what we have to deduct? Municipal taxes at the rate, this is 10% on MRV. You have to take always. Okay, municipal taxes always percentage you have to take on MRV. So MRV is how much? 1,75,000 MRV. Okay, so MRV is 1,75,000. On 1,75,000, if you do 10%, it will be 17,500. Next, one more tax is there. What is the tax? Sanitation charges. One more tax is there. So he says 5% on municipal taxes. He says 5% on municipal taxes here. Plus 5% of municipal taxes as sanitizer charges. Sanitizing surcharge means tax. So 5% of municipal tax. So 17,500 into 5%. 17,500 into 5%. So you are getting 875. Okay. So deduct from 1,80,000 minus 17,500 minus 875. You are getting 1,61,625. What is this? Net annual value. Okay, so this is about NAV. So what we have seen here, the new point here we have seen, that is sanitation charges. Okay, so municipal taxes is always calculated on MRV, remember this. And on MRV, on municipal taxes, he is saying charge 5% as sanitization charges. So we have taken 875 and the net NAV is 1,61,625. Easy. Check. Next one, we will do one more problem. See here. Page number 196, problem number 7. See what he says. A is the owner of the following properties. So he is the owner of these two properties. MRV, FRV, standard rent, actual rent, municipal taxes is given. Date of construction is given for the both the houses. See, 1/4/2014, 1/8/2010. So both the houses he has given the date of construction. So both the houses date of construction is after 1/4/1999. I repeat, both the houses date of construction is after 1/4/1999. So we have to remember actual interest paid or max 2 lakhs. For both the houses, actual interest paid or max 2 lakhs, whichever is less, that we have to consider. Next, severance tax we have to consider. extended collection charges, no need. Annual charges, no need. Ground rent loan, no need. This all we don't need. Do not need rent collection charges, we don't want. Annual charges, we don't want. Ground rent, we don't want this all, these three. Okay, interest on loan is 17,200 and 10,000. Okay, and you have to find out income from house property. And see how to know the house property is self-occupied or let out by seeing actual rent. The let out property, self-occupied property rent will not be there. Actual rent will not be there. Only this actual rent will be for house let out properties will be there. Okay, so we have to solve the problem for house 1 and house 2. Chale, start solving. We'll start solving this problem. I'll do here house 1 GAV page number is 196 question number 7. Okay, so we'll find out GAV of house 1. House 1 GAV we'll find out. If possible we'll find out two houses GAV here only. House 1 and here we will find out house 2. We know it's easy, right? It's easy to find out GAV. First step 1 is what? ERV. We know first step 1 is what? ERV. How to find out ERV? MRV or FRV? Whichever is high. So how much we are having MRV? 80 or 90,000? MRV is 80,000. FRV is 90,000. Highest is what? 90,000. We got ERV as 90. Step 2 is what? Adjusted ERV. How to find out standard rent or ERV? Whichever is low. So standard rent is, how much is there standard rent for house 1? 60,000. So 60,000 and ERV is how much? 90,000. So from the low is how much? 60,000. What is 60,000? Adjusted ERV. Step 3. GAV. How to find GAV? Adjusted ERV or ARV. Adjusted ERV is 60,000 and ARV given in for us house is 1 lakh. So GAV is 1 lakh. So house 1 we have calculated GAV. It's 1 lakh. Easy. Okay. So house 1 we have calculated. Let us move further for house 2. Okay. Again we have to find out ERV. How to find out ERV for house 2? MRV or FRV, whichever is what? High. So for house 1, 2, MRV is 60,000, FRV is 75,000. 60,000 and 75,000. 60,000, 75,000. Highest is 75,000. So ERV is 75,000. Next, step 2. What we have to find on step 2? Adjusted ERV. So adjusted ERV is what? Low. So what we have to consider? We have to consider standard rent and ERV, whichever is low. Standard rent is how much per stand house to? 60,000. So standard rent is 60,000 and this is 75,000. So low between the two is 60. Adjusted ERV is 60,000. Next, Roman number 3. We have to find out GAV. So for GAV is what? Formula adjusted ERV and ARV. Adjusted ERV is 60,000 and ARV for house 2 is 50,000. So we are getting GAV as 60,000. Okay, chali. We got both the houses GAV, first house is 1 lakh and second house is 60,000. So let us solve this problem on the next page. So heading will be computation of income from house property. Of Mr. A for the EY 20 and 21. Okay, so there is house 1, this is house 2. Okay, let us start. For house 1, GAV is gross annual value is 1 lakh. For house 2 is how much? 60,000. House 2 is 60,000. Okay, next, minus municipal taxes. Okay, house 1 is 10%, house 2 is 15%. At the rate, H1 is 10%, house 2 is 15%. So MRV of house 1 is 80 and house 2 is 60. Into 80,000 into 60,000. Remember, this is always on MRV. So first house we are getting 8,000, second house we are getting 60,000 into 15%, 9,000 we are getting. Okay, one more tax we have to deduct, that is what? Severance tax. How much is severance tax for house 1? 4,000, house 2 is 2,000. 4,000, house 2 is 2,000. Deduct 1 lakh minus 8,000 minus 4,000. So you get 88,000. House 1 you are getting 88,000, house 2 will get 60,000 minus 9,000 minus 2,000. 49,000 you are getting. Okay, so house 2 you are getting 49,000. So write this as net annual value. Okay, so next is deductions. Deductions under section 24. First is 24A. 24A standard deduction. At the rate 30% on for house 1 88,000 and 30% on house 2 49,000. So this is NAV. So standard deduction will be always on NAV. So house 1 30% of 88,000, house 2 is 30% of 49,000. Okay, so let me do 88,000 into 30%. We are getting 26,400. House 2, 49,000 into 30%, 14,700. Okay, next is what? 24B. What is 24B? Interest on loan. Okay, for both the houses, house 1 interest on loan is 17,200, house 2 is 10,000. House 2 is what? 10,000. Okay, see, we are not considering, we don't want date of construction because this is let out property. Let out property, there are no conditions, directly you have to take this interest. Okay, but let out properties you have to take directly whatever is given. So I wrote here, right, in the first exam, here I explained you. Okay, for let out properties there will be no condition for let out properties. Interest on loan, there is no condition for let out properties. So we'll deduct this. See, 88,000 minus 26,400 minus 17,200. We are getting 44,400. if something is going wrong. Let me check. ₹1 lakh. Yes, it is right only. So see this once. So for interest on loan, for let out property, there is no condition. Directly how much is given, that much you have to write. We have written here. Okay. It be. So what we have done, that is right. This problem we'll do one more time with making some changes. So here 88,000 minus 26,400 minus 17,200, we're getting 44,400. 44,400. And here we are getting 49,000 minus 14,700 minus 10,000, 24,300. So this is income from house property. Okay, so this is income from house property. In this problem, we have assumed municipal taxes is paid by owner. We have assumed paid by owner. Our assumption is that in this problem, the municipal taxes is paid by the owner we have to take. Okay, and when we should deduct municipal taxes, it should be paid by owner. Paid, it should be paid, and that should be paid by owner. If it is paid by tenant, it will not, we should not deduct. Okay, if it is paid by tenant, we should not take. Only it should be paid by owner, then we have to consider. Okay, so this same problem, same, you have to solve again the problem. This problem, GAV will get same, you'll get this interest on loan same. So what is changing? NAV and standard deduction will change. See how? See here, I want you to solve this problem. See. Municipal taxes of house A as paid by the tenant. So who is paying the municipal taxes of house A? Tenant is paying. So house A, we should not take municipal taxes. I want you to solve this problem. So don't take municipal taxes for house A, your house one, because it is paid by owner, tenant. If it is paid by tenant, do not consider. Next, what he says, and house two, well, that house two are outstanding. So house three is outstanding. Again, house two outstanding means should not take. It should be paid. Outstanding and paid by tenant is not allowed. If any municipal taxes, outstanding is not allowed and paid by tenant is not allowed. So I want you to solve the problem without writing GST municipal taxes. You should not write municipal taxes. Okay, just directly write 1 lakh minus 4,000, 96,000 you will get, 60,000 minus 2,000 you get 58,000. Like that you solve. So why I'm saying means, in this problem he is saying do not pay municipal taxes paid by the tenant. House 1, so do not consider. House 2 also, who is paying? Outstanding. So do not consider. So this problem again you solve. You solve again, the everything remains same. JAV will be same. Civil tax will be same. Interest on loan will be same. What is changing? Don't write municipal taxes, but don't write the amount 8,000 and 9,000. Here 9,000. Write directly 1 lakh minus 4,000, 96,000, 60,000 minus 2,000, 49,000. Sorry, 60,000 minus 2,000, 58,000. Again on this you get 96,000 into 30% you will get, right, do here, and 58,000 into 30% you do, house 2 you write, and same is you will get answer. okay, and you should get answer for house one is 50,000 income from house property, and house two you should get 30,600. Okay, so I wanted to solve the problem again. So I'll send the picture of this question. Please try this problem, it's very easy. Then tomorrow's class we'll see pre-construction interest. So we have covered it till now in this chapter. How to find out GAV, we know municipal taxes also we have seen just now, okay, net annual value, standard deduction also seen, interest on loan we have seen, condition also we have seen in example, pre-construction interest we'll see in next class, and we'll do problems on pre-construction interest. Okay, so I want you to practice this entire things till now what we have solved. Chaliye, let us stop the class here, and tomorrow I'll upload problems on pre-construction interest. Chaliye, thank you.